You want to talk to a bullshit artist? He's a great speaker. That's why Clinton was one of the great speakers of all time. Because he was a degenerate liar. And if you're lying all the time, you can never be effective and nobody will believe you unless he's a great speaker. If we had to talk about Monica Lewinsky and he talked like Bush, would he have convinced anybody? Would he have convinced anybody if he talked like Bush? He had to talk tough and he had to be fluent. He said, I never had sex with Monica Lewinsky. And everybody said, oh, yeah, bro. Imagine if he talked like Bush and he said, I never had sex. Sex, no kidding. Yeah, with Monica. Who? Lewinsky. Lewinsky! Everybody would have said guilty without an explanation and he would have been wiped out. And I'm not making fun of Clinton either. Everybody likes to make fun of him. He was a great man, and he was a great man, and he was a great president. Nobody knows what a great president he is because he didn't get involved in politics. It's not his business. He had no time for politics. He was busy going from house to house. Hello, are you busy? I don't make fun of him because he committed adultery, because I don't even care if he committed adultery. The fact is that he was a democratic type of an adulterer. Whoever showed up, close enough, better than nothing. Hello, are you busy? Better than nothing. Give me. Every time you saw him, he was in shorts and running, people think he was doing exercise. What exercise? He was going from house to house. Why do you think he was always in shorts? Had no time to put his pants on. That's it. Do you understand this? I like a guy like Clinton. I don't need people with a conscience about decency. It's not important. He stole everything. First he was attacking women, then he was attacking whoever showed up. Then he started robbing houses. Do you remember how he robbed the White House? He took out the chairs, the tables, the furniture. He stole everything from the White House. There's nothing left there. The toilets were thrown, everything. They don't even have a staircase now anymore. You have to go up and down with a rope now. That's it. First he denied it. He said, I didn't take nothing. Remember that? First he denied it. They said, but we have proof. He said, oh, you have proof? Why didn't you say so? Now he has a whole new excuse. He said he didn't even mean to take it. He forgot to leave it. Let's face it, the man is a sick liar, and that's it. I don't like to talk about politics. It's not my nature. I know there's a lot of people defensive about Clinton because people love Clinton, especially if they're Jewish. They don't care what he does. Right now, if he shot somebody right in the heart, every Jew in this building would say, who lives forever? Jews don't care what he does. He could do anything. They say, he didn't mean it. It's not his nature. They're picking on him. He raped a girl. So what? It's one girl. It's not like he raped a lot of girls. Look how many girls he didn't rape. There's so many girls he didn't. You think he wanted to rape her? It's her own fault. If she wasn't there, it never would have happened. What do you... He didn't want to do it. His pants were on the floor. So what is he going to do? He made the best of it. It's not his nature. Do you understand this? He doesn't mean any harm. He's just a natural liar, and that's it. People don't like to—they don't like to hear him called a liar. The fact is, he's a sick liar. He was even disbarred from practicing law. Do you people notice? He was disbarred from practicing law. This man is too big a liar to be a lawyer. That's why I say I don't want to get involved in politics. Look how he pardoned Mark Rich, a degenerate, sick, disgusting, low-life pig like Mark Rich. I don't like to call people names. It's not my nature. Ran away with $300 million of taxpayer money, wound up in the Bahamas with 27 19-year-old girls, left his wife and children, and wound up with 19-year-old girls jumping on his lap in the Bahamas. And when they asked Clinton, why did you pardon him? Did you hear what he said about why he pardoned him? He actually said this. He said he suffered enough. He's steady stuff. You know what it is to be away from your wife and children and have to be in the Bahamas away from your family with 19-year-old girls jumping all around you? This is the dream of every Jew in the world. You think he wanted to run away from those 19-year-old girls and get back to his wife and hear a yenta hollering, "Where were you?" Let's not get involved in this whole thing. I don't want to make fun of Bush. It's bad taste to make fun of either one of them. These are the great leaders of our country. It's like Sharon said yesterday. Do you hear what Derek Sharon said? He made a speech I'll never forget. This man is one of the great speakers of all time. Did you hear what Sharon said? He said, "The tragedy, we did it. Before that, we did it. We have to hakak it. We don't have to, the Arabs, fools out of the bitches. The Arabs was the commander of it in the game. The Arabs, they did it. They come back it to the video. The what? We did it, it's out of the bitches. We don't have to, And everybody said, "The man is right." He hasn't got an easy job. Everybody is picking on him. They wanted to give the whole West Bank back to the Palestinians. Did you hear about it? He'd like to give it back. Right now he can't. It's in his wife's name. I'm not worried about Israel. Israel's going to survive this war and they'll win this whole thing because we are the toughest army in the world. People don't notice that the toughest army in the world is the Israeli army. Man for man. Man for man, the toughest army. Every military analyst agrees that the toughest army in the world today is the Israeli army. That's right. Why do you think in the 67 we won the first war with a Jewish general, couldn't even see what he was doing? The younger people here probably never heard of him. His name was Moshe Dayan, the guy with the patch. Remember him with the patch? He was the general with the patch, spent the whole war walking around. Where the hell is this goddamn war? It was a lucky thing the Arabs came from this side.